then put on your phone, too.
No, I don't want to do it. It's already over, you know, halfway through it.
Okay, come on, let's go. I'm doing good. How are you doing? Jenny Stevenson.
I brought my
good
morning.
My husband and I would like to talk to you.
Good.
Have a peppermint.
I would like to have a peppermint. You doing okay?
I am doing awesomely. Thank you.
You sweetie.
How
you doing? Here
you go. I'm gonna go ahead and turn this down.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's a mess in here.
That's
all right.
It's the way I live.
There's your coffee.
Thank you.
Okay.
Well, I'm trying to figure out what is going on.
Okay.
And why I just thought it was inconsiderate.
That what?
That it was inconsiderate for you, since we've had an email exchange about me being the area chair, and you said to come in and talk to you.
Yeah.
And you never got back with me or anything, but you just told me there was no vacancy.
Well, there's not a vacancy right now. That's
Kathleen, there was at the time Kathleen Oates stepped down.
Kathleen Oates has not told me she's stepping down.
Ron Roach is the precinct chair.
He is the precinct chair, but she is the area chair.
So area chairs cannot be precinct chairs?
Yes.
So which ones do we have? Wally, what's going on? There's just some kind of game because...
I'm sorry you're paranoid about it.
Oh, I'm not paranoid. I just have a little...
I have no anything against you at all. I'm not trying to plot against you or whatever it is you think is going on. I'm just telling you that the area chairs can or cannot be precinct chairs.
So you want me to call Kathleen right now and ask her if she wants to be it, and if she doesn't, I can?
No, call her and talk to her.
I ain't calling right now.
Well, no.
Why?
Well, I want to talk to her.
Well, she's not going to do it. You know that she stepped down. I don't know of any of the other area chairs that are not precinct chairs, Wally.
What?
There's none of them, Wally.
That may be true, yeah. But that doesn't matter.
And then I have been a precinct chair for 4 years, and Mark Frank just steps in, and you make him area chair.
Because he and I talked about it. We had a vacancy. We didn't have an area chair, and I appointed him. Look, this is an organization that we created. It's not routine in every county that they have area chairs.
No, it's not.
Yeah, right. And this is what we created. And I don't know what the deal is with you about that, but they are appointed by me.
Well,
the area chairs are appointed by me.
You're not being considerate. I send you emails, and you don't...
When we have a position open.
Let me know when I can talk.
Pardon?
Just let me know when I can speak.
You can speak now.
I send you emails and I ask you questions and you respond to me, John Wirtz, like John, I'm married to John Wirtz, and I'm not. This is my husband, Calvin Russell. So I don't talk to John all the time. You don't answer my question. Yeah, you'll respond to me and you will tell me, I've already spoken to John Wirtz about this, and I'm like, why would he say that? I'm not married to him.
I don't remember even mentioning John.
Well, I'll send it. I'll send.
What was it about?
About Wally appointing a precinct chair without bringing him to the nominating committee.
Oh, that was an error on my part.
How can somebody that's been in your position that long make that kind of error?
Well, we all make mistakes sometimes.
Wally, you don't make that kind of error.
Now, Ginger, if we want to get along, I think we can talk and be considerate of each other. And I'm not going to carry on a conversation where you're going to attack me at every level.
Wally, I've never really spoken to you that much. I've just emailed exchange with you. You don't answer my emails. Even today, I've asked you twice, who have you appointed as the area chair? And you won't respond to me.
We have an area chair right now. She's Kathleen. And she has not resigned, and I have to talk to her before I will appoint someone there. I think that's routine situation. I think I'll have that opportunity.
Has Kathleen told you that she resigned?
Kathleen.
She resigned as precinct chair.
But not as area chair.
Yeah, but there's not, to my knowledge, ever been an area chair that's not a precinct chair.
Well, that doesn't mean there can be.
But there is now, because he hasn't found somebody to take the area chair position. I'm willing to, but I think I know, and I think you know, that you don't want me to do it. You really don't want me to be precinct chair.
Well, you're presuming a lot of wrong,
Jim. Well, that's a good question. You don't mind me interjecting.
No,
do you have any problem with her being the area chair?
Well, I think there is a problem in my mind, because an area chair needs to be a united person that's going to be able to work with everybody. And for whatever reason, Ginger's had a problem doing that. And I'm willing to work with her and to cooperate with her as a precinct chairman. But when I had a conversation with anybody that's going to be an area chair, they have to understand that as an area chair, you need to be able to work with all the precinct chairs, and you do not need to be out taking a strong position for or any candidate, so that it makes it look like, you know, you're out there recruiting the other precinct chairs to be for a candidate. So we're trying to build an organization where if a precinct chair wants to back a candidate, that's fine, no problem. But we need to be consistent in how we're going to go about doing that. And I just I had a long conversation with Martin Frank before he took the position. And he understands my position on that. And if we run into a problem and he can't do that, I'll replace him and put somebody else in.
So what do you want them to do? Just do whatever you say?
I want them to work with the other precinct chairs to call and be a liaison between me as the county chair and the precinct chair, to encourage them all to come to the meetings, every one of them to come to the meetings, and to when we're in a campaign activity in the general election, to be more or less supervising over the precinct chairs to make sure that they're doing what we set out a plan to do. And in the last general election, we had a lot of precinct chairs that never did. And Mr. Wirtz didn't even support the ticket.
Okay, I am not married to Mr. Wirtz.
And he is not going to ever be an area chair. He's just not going to be.
So, if I can ask another question, yeah, if
sure.
You guys don't want me in the conversation, because I don't,
yeah, no,
yeah,
I have no problem.
I'm just trying to find out myself. Whenever you say that that they
you don't want, let's say the ginger supporting a Republican on the, that's on the ticket, and she and
we're
she.
We're talking about, excuse me for interrupting. We're talking about in the primary.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. In the primary.
Go ahead.
Yeah. Maybe I misunderstood your comment, but like right now the county commissioners race. You know, where you got Charlie Roddy and Brian Dawson and Gregory Parker.
Right.
Well, if she is it wrong for her to support one, but not just support her, but her to talk to the precinct chairs and say, hey, I'm supporting this guy, and this is why I'm supporting him, and I wish you'd support him as well. Is that wrong for a precinct chair to do that, or are you only talking about in the general?
I'm talking about in the primary.
Okay, in the primary. So it's right.
She can talk to the other preaching chairs about it. I just don't want our area chairs to be outspoken and to try to continue to work on the precinct chair. After you've had a conversation with them, they know where she stands, and they know where they stand. And we let it go with that.
Okay. I'm just trying to understand it.
That's fine.
So in other words, you don't want someone in an area chair position to try to strong arm the other precinct chairs to vote the way they want to vote.
That's correct.
Okay, I understand. I was just curious.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. And I think anybody, if we're going to have a cohesive organization, we need to have relationships that are not going to be adversarial. We need to work more together than against each other. And
to what end?
There's an old, used to be an old cartoon strip called Pogo. And Pogo said one time, we have met the enemy, and the enemy is us.
Yeah, remember that.
And I don't want that.
Yeah.
We need to be working together.
Are you conservative?
Of course I am. Are you?
Extremely. Extremely. And I think that sometimes...
if you want me to be quiet a little...
No, I like
what's
it.
What's the best way, Dr. Wally, if you're conservative, and I don't doubt that, and we're conservative, but whenever you see things going on within the party, and it's your own, the enemy is us sometimes, is right, but... within your own party, whenever they're not moving towards a conservative issue, like a good example is our legislators in Congress. Well, Joe Strauss is one, and whenever you see them supporting the Democrat and the liberal point of view, I mean, even though we're all Republicans and we put an R beside our name to get elected. Where do you draw the line and say, well, that you're not operating under Republican conservative principles. You're really operating as a Democrat running as a Republican. And how do we do that without being the enemy to our party?
Well, first of all, do you know Joe Strauss?
Not personally, no.
Okay.
No.
I do.
Okay.
I served with his mother on the state Republican Executive Committee when it wasn't popular to be a Republican, let alone a conservative.
Okay.
Joe Strauss spent years working in Washington with former Senator John Tower, a very, very conservative person. And so I think to a great extent he gets a bum rap. Now, he was elected under unusual circumstances, no question.
Yeah.
Simply because he doesn't happen to agree with the bathroom bill or whatever, we're going to remove him from office. I think it's a little bit too much.
That would be too much if that was the only thing. But there's several things where the people that he appoints to the committees as committee chairs and the legislation that he stops from getting to the floor. I mean, it goes on. I mean, it's not just one thing. I mean,
you realize that it's a customary deal in the House for either Republicans or Democrats to appoint members of the opposition party to be chairs.
Yeah, I do understand that, but I also understand that they try to do that in such a way where the chairs that they're appointing are not how can I say it, the most important one to get the legislation through that you want to get through. I mean, I'm just saying that I know that Joe Strauss.
I understand where you're coming from. I know the argument.
Okay.
And I've heard it many times.
Well, I mean, are they all false, Doctor? And I hope you don't think I'm being adversarial. It depends
on what side of the fence you're on.
What about
whenever? Some of these things, we can have differences of opinion about as Republican conservatives. And it just so happens that bathroom bill is one of them. And just because one side doesn't believe in that they're automatically not conservative, they're liberal, or they're Democrat, is a little bit far-fetched.
So what would you say, I mean, if you found out that one of your precinct chairs, or your area chairs even, was contributing heavily to a Democrat that was running for office?
Well, in that case, I would ask him to step down.
Well, don't you believe that Joe Strauss is doing that?
No.
If we bring you proof to that, would that change your mind about Joe Strauss?
Sir, I've been in this business since 1962.
There's no doubt.
I've seen them come and go.
Hey, there's no doubt that you're smarter
than I am, Wally. I'm not trying to say that.
I just asked you a straightforward question.
I'm just trying to say that I believe I'm in a position to know what I believe and what somebody believes.
Okay.
And we can have a difference of opinion about Joe Strauss. I don't go out here and get on the stump and preach for Joe Strauss,
right,
and I'm not going to preach against him.
No, but you support him.
But my question.
Well, he's our speaker. I'm going to support
Go ahead.
Let me go. I asked you.
Well, you and I just disagree. That's all.
Yeah. I have a straightforward question to you. Was this? If I can bring you absolute proof that Joe Strauss is contributing to Democrats, would that change your mind?
You're talking about contributing money?
Yes, sir.
Well, I imagine he may have done that. I don't know.
That doesn't affect your thoughts of him?
I would not approve of that.
But you still support him?
I would support someone as, well, I mean, just me. I mean,
look, I'm not supporting or being against Joe Strauss. He's not in my realm. I'm here in Montgomery County.
But he's our speaker, like you said.
He certainly
is a speaker.
And he affects a lot of our legislation.
Well, and apparently he must do a pretty good job to get reelected.
No, that doesn't mean that has to do with...
So Obama did a good job?
If you don't like Joe Strauss as the whipping boy,
he's just one thing that's totally wrong with all this. I was trying to give you an example of whatever.
I'm willing to listen to any examples that I've heard of all.
Okay. So what you're saying then, is, if I understand you correctly, is that what would it take for you to say, this guy's a Republican, but he shouldn't be running on the Republican ticket? What would he have to do in your mind to make that happen?
Look, you or I or no Republican has any right to tell somebody that they're not a Republican. We don't have that right.
I'm not saying that he can't, but
well,
but would you? I would
certainly
hope.
I'm not going to judge somebody and say because of one issue or whatever that they're not a Republican.
You cannot, Wally.
I understand that we have to work together.
Oh, really?
Did you think that I don't?
So well, I don't know. I'm wondering.
Well, really?
So we have to agree with everything you say.
No.
That's what you want. You want all the precinct chairs to get in line and rubber stamp your agenda.
Absolutely. I don't have an agenda.
Okay.
Well, okay. Like I said, I don't know. I don't know if I'm just not explaining myself correctly or not, but it just appears to me that there's not a clear line that you say, look, you can't cross this line and still call yourself a Republican. You know, you just can't. I mean, and I think that there's so many good examples, and, you know, I certainly don't want the Democrats to win. Certainly don't want the Democrats to win. But there's so many examples, I think, of when we work hard and give our money and support the Republican candidate, mm-hmm. and then they get in office and then they act just like the Democrats, we've wasted our time and effort and treasure, you know, and that's just the way that I look at it. And I'm,
And well, that's fine. It's your prerogative, and I appreciate that.
I wouldn't go around criticizing you for that position.
That's what you want to take.
My position is that as the chairman of the whole party,
I'm not going to be able to pick and choose who I might oppose or support within our party structure.
Ginger.
Somebody has to be the one that keeps everybody together. And if I'm going to take a strong position for or against somebody or something, and that's going to create a problem, I don't think that's in the best interest of our party locally.
Maybe you're right.
And I appreciate your position. I have no problem. I mean, I understand how you feel.
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
I just don't happen to agree altogether with that. But because I don't, that doesn't make me less Republican.
No. Well, yeah, you're certainly a solid Republican. Yeah. In all fairness,
sometimes, well, let me just say this. I learned a long time ago that there's a difference between campaigning and governing.
Yeah.
And you can say and want and be for a lot of things when you campaign. But if you're going to go to the House or Senate or to Washington, you're going to have to be able to get along with the people and work with people in order to get whatever agenda you have put in effect. And you can't say it's all my way all the time or I'm not going to be a part of it. And if you do that, my position has been, my experience has been, when you're wrong, so you don't get everything you want, you usually get nothing.
Yeah.
Sometimes you have to bend a little bit, not your principles, but bend your position in order to accomplish something. And a good example of that is in Washington. But in Austin, when Mark Keogh won the election, first time, I didn't know Mark Keogh. And we had a long conversation. I congratulated him. He said to me, "Do you have any advice?" I said, "Yeah, I'm going to have some advice for you. And when you go to Austin, we need more than just a seat from Montgomery County.
More than what?
A seat, a chair. We need someone that's going to be able to work with his fellow Republicans and sometimes Democrats to accomplish something. And if you can't get that done, you're not going to be successful in Austin. Now, just because you might have to work with somebody you don't particularly support, that doesn't mean that it's wrong. And Mark went to Austin. He did almost exactly what I'm talking about. And he had a very successful career there. I was quite honestly very surprised when he decided not to run for re-election and to run for a different office. Because I think he had done a good job for our county. And that we didn't agree on every issue we didn't agree on, but I respect him.
You think he'll make a good judge?
Well, I think he, when compared to the incumbent, he doesn't have, obviously, the experience, but I think he could.
Yeah, well, I mean, nobody's going to have the experience unless they've been a judge, I guess.
Well, that's true.
Yeah.
That's true. So I'm sorry that y'all or Ginger has a feeling like I'm plotting against her or something like that. That's absolutely not true.
So what would she have to do to have you consider her then?
Well, I think that she would have to prove to me that she would be able to work with all the precinct chairs regardless.
Who am I not working with?
Regardless of whether she might agree with them on the candidate or an issue.
Who am I not working with?
We were just supposing you were in that position. What?
Who?
I don't know who you're not working with.
Well, you have obviously assumed that I'm not working with the precinct chairs. Where do you come up with that? I've been a precinct chair for 4 years.
I wanted to be sure that you could.
Okay, so, I'll work with the precinct chairs.
Okay.
How does she prove that to you?
I mean, Mark can come in here not being one, and somehow his verbiage has come across to you that he's going to be a whatever Wally's looking for. And I've been a precinct chair for you.
I can assure you that if he's not, he won't keep the position.
To me, really, Wally, it's not my life skill to be an area chair. It really isn't. My problem and even in coming, no, I don't really want it that bad.
Okay.
My deal is you. You send me emails.
Well, I'm not saying that you're my problem.
You're inconsiderate to me is what you are, Wally. You're inconsiderate. That's my email. Yeah, you're exactly right, but my email exchanges to you are like you talk to me.
You're awfully sensitive about it.
No, I'm not sensitive. I'm very small. I send them to a lot of precinct chairs that get to read over them. So it isn't just me. I send your emails to some friends that know you a lot better than I do that said this is, you know, I'm not sensitive.
Okay.
But I'm not stupid either, Wally. Okay, let's go. I came in here to find out what I thought was going on, and I found out exactly what I thought was going on. So, I hope you have a good day. I'm done.
Tell me what you thought.
It is exactly what I thought.
What was that?
No, Wally. Come on, I'm ready. Thank you, Wally. We'll see you in the next executive meeting.
Thank you very much.
You bet.
See y'all later.
Bye, Janine. Bye. You have a great day, girl. Bye-bye.